All right, boys, me and Sawyer back out here. Trying to catch some bass off.
Plus.
Whoa, what just happened to you?
Can't throw me in the water.
Oh, chill. I'm fishing a square bill, Sawyer's fishing lipless. Probably just gonna be fishing, huh?
I'm not fishing a lipless. Belly weighted, shad color swim bait.
Why would you not fish a crankbait?
I will. Hmm. I'll just see how this is gonna do.
Yeah, there's like a friggin' ton of grass in this pond today. Way grassier than it normally is. Not a fan. No. At all. But I think we're still gonna get on quite a few fish today. I've already caught one, like right before I threw on the chesty. This rattle trap's seen its better days. It's currently got one eye rocking. Still has paint on it though. Sawyer just missed the hook set. Look at that. What did y'all have for breakfast today, Sawyer? Some unfrosted Pop-Tarts?
No, we had.
Sounds like an immediate emergency toilet visit.
Oh, I did.
Yeah.
Right after.
Yeah, I can imagine. That
it
just
was, it was
like I can just.
It was liquid,
oh, man. Yeah, I can imagine. No, you know what's unfortunate? The fact that I have to take a fat dookie right now. I caught a fish.
My gosh.
You caught a friggin'. Was yeah. that a friggin'?
It's my first fish of the day. Little dink. Good old rattle trap fish.
Juice.
Clear water bassin?
Clear water bass. Why are you horsing?
Nice.
Oh my gosh. Why would you do that? Why'd you throw him like that? He just soaked me. Then you're gonna be like, at least I'll give it until 4 before Sawyer dips. Because he's gonna think about food and he's like, I also gotta get a shower before Bible study. He's like, but we could go get some food real quick and then go home and we could both get showers and sit in the AC, play some Fortnite. Dude, that smart food popcorn looks delectable.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I might have to bust open a bag of that soon. Whoa. Oh, we got one right here, right by the boat.
Yeah.
Where is the drag at?
Nice.
Perfect. Quick release. That's what we like to see. Why is there no drag on this reel? I don't know, dude. Makes me want to cry. Couldn't even get the fish on the boat. How are you going to own 30 pairs of swimming trunks but never go in the water, Joe Rogan?
No.
When is it too hot to be fishing? Answer to that question is today. Today's about the answer to that question. Get some cold cuts. Get some cold cuts. Get some cold cuts. Wow. Such a good commercial. That was like one of my favorite ones. Jeez, dog. Even my hands are sweating.
Yeah.
I just have water dripping off me. Oh, we got a fish.
Did it?
No. But it is a fish nonetheless. Matter of fact, it's straight towards us. Yeah. What is this tiny little bass? Is this the same one I just had a second ago? Another one off the old lipless. Hopefully we can catch some more. It is so hot. But if we were like slamming them, it would take my mind off the heat. Like if we could catch like 10 in a row, it'd be nice, right?
Oh,
damn. Say nipply?
Yeah.
You mean nippy?
Yeah.
I don't think nipply is the right term. But lens popped out. Sawyer's screwed for the rest of the day.
You know what? I'm not even worried about it.
As soon as they do that, I just want to rip it, but...
That's it over there. It keeps being giant.
Oh, hold on, hold on. Got him that time. Yes, sir. All right, boys, I think the Senko's the wave, dog. And he just... No way I lost. Ow. Let me get the freaking... Oh. That's what we like to see. It's what we like to feel, and that's what we like to... Wait, we're like here, so we like to see, so we like to feel. There it is.
One little double.
Little double up, boys.
This segment of the video is brought to you by God's Holy Word. Today we're going to read from John 14, verse 6. This is also my favorite verse. And it says, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. This is just a constant reminder that Jesus is the only way. There is no other way. Not by our works or our deeds or the things that we do. And no matter how good we try to be, the only way is Jesus. So just keep that in mind. Let's get right back to the video.
Dude, you are a pasty little man. There he is. Oh, dude, this is a stud McGee. Oh, yeah, buddy.
The tank.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
Please do not spit, Father. Help me to land this fish.
He's probably probably 5.5, 6. That mouth though, if in spawn, he's definitely a lot bigger.
Oh yeah, boys, that is a stud, McGee.
What are you getting a shirt on for?
Because I need this moment to be a good moment that I look back at, and I don't want to look crazy.
Dude, it's always the lipless, ain't it?
It is always and forever will be the lipless. All right, we're gonna get a weight on this guy. Give me the fish. Let's dip him in the water real quick. Make sure he stays alive. Skill's at 0.
Or 0.
This is probably a 5.5 pounder.
Yeah, 5.5. 5.5. Let it be a third one. 5.5, 13.
Stud fish. Good quality bass right there. Gonna get a couple picks. Mm-hmm. Here she goes. Whoa. Big, nice, beautiful bass. That is so sexy.
Again, cheat code for summer and all year round is legitimately the lipless. Oh, goodness. Another one on the day, guys. On the lipless. Foul hooked. Get this out of him. All right, boys, there he is, another little guy on the lipless. All right, anyways, the fish I just caught, that 5-pounder, came right out of the middle, set the hook and thought it was just a bunch of grass or a log at first because it wasn't really moving, just a lot of weight. Quickly realized it was a nice fish though.
I think they went airborne too.
Yeah, I know. He looked a lot bigger out there.
Yeah, I know. His mouth was huge.
Yeah, it was a bucket. Yeah, anyways, guys, I'm using a natural shad, lipless crankbait. Throwing it on a 7-foot medium heavy fast action rod, 14-pound mono, Shimano Corrado DC, Scorpion DC. Slow rolling it, popping it here and there. Produces good fish. There he is again. Got another one, boys. On the lipless. Little guy. Yeah, but for you fishermen out there who don't have, I know we probably say this in a lot of our videos, but they don't have live scope or a nice graph, some good imagery, even a decked off boat, John boat fishermen, summertime. Throw the lipless, whatever color bait fish you have and the body of water you're fishing, throw that color shad in this, so it's just natural shad lipless, and slaying them right now. There he is. I missed him. No, dude, what is this? Bluegill on the lipless is crazy. Look at that, guys. Bluegill on the lipless. Someone's calling me. Pretty little fish. No. Yeah. Good fish. Another fish for Gus on the lipless. Oh, crappy. Nice. Multi-species today, fellas. Multi-species. I whip that, huh? There he is. Got another one, boys. Another one on the lipless. We're doubled up. Oh my. What? Almost got hooked. There he goes. There he is. Another one, fellas. I'll keep mine until Gus gets his in. Look at that, boys. Double, oh, whoop. Yep, there they go. Gus got another fish.
Favorite cereal swim. Oh, this might be a tank.
Actually?
No, never mind. Favorite cereal swim.
Favorite cereal? You favorite. Can't, listen, if you guys watched the last episode of me and Gus fishing, maybe not, maybe it's the episode before the last, but we talked about waffles and pancakes and Waffle House and Pop-Tarts. Today he has just asked me a question that really cannot be answered. He asked me, what's my favorite cereal?
Give me a top five, not in order.
I can't give you a top five. We have to do order. Top five
top
like...
Top five, not in order.
Listen.
Oh my God.
You have to do like a top five fruity. You have to do a top five with marshmallows. You have to do a top five Frosted Mini Wheats.
Dude, there's only two really good cereals with marshmallows.
No.
Yeah. 100%. What is another good cereal with marshmallows other than Lucky Charms and Fruit Loops? Yeah, exactly.
Oh, that's a good question. Blueberry? Ooh. Blueberry's pretty good.
Yeah,
Count Chocula?
That doesn't have cream. It does not have marshmallows.
I was just saying it's a good cereal. Okay, Gus, top five, you ready? No order. We're just random. There can't be an order. Apple Jacks.
Applejack.
Yes.
The number one spot.
No, not number one. No order.
Number one spot.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Cookie Crisp.
Valid.
Fruit Loops with marshmallows.
Valid.
Golden Grahams. Top five cereals. What's yours?
Captain Crunch.
Captain Crunch.
Fruit Loops with marshmallows.
Okay.
Fruity Pebbles.
Okay.
Cookie Crisp.
Uh huh.
Cinnamon Life.
Oh, Cinnamon Life. Dude, cinnamon, guys, if you haven't had Cinnamon Life, I don't know what you're doing.
This is like one of the greatest cereals on this planet.
Dude, it is so good.
Oh my gosh.
It's Life cereal, but cinnamon flavored.
Yeah.
And it's chronic.
And every time it rains, panties from heaven.
Shoo-be-doo-be.
Don't you know each cloud contains panties from heaven?
Shoo-be-doo-be.
You'll find your fortune falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is up, upside down. And trade them for a package of sunshine and ravioli.
Macaroni!
If you want the things you love, you must have a pizzaoli, baby. And when you hear thunder, don't run under.